So we're
going to
talk about that clapping today, right?
I sure hope not. I sure hope not. My gosh. But why don't you start off like that, Craig?
I'm trying to light.
Oh, it's light already. But, well, we had 3 great days of practice, and, you know, our guys, I think, are, you know, cranked up, ready to go. You know, we got some great tape evaluation in, and I think we know what they like to do. And, you know, they're very talented football team, as I told you Monday. The more tape you watch, the more, you know, big and physical and athletic you see that they really are. So we'll have our work cut out for us, and we're looking forward to heading out to Stillwater tomorrow morning.
Is this the kind of game, Pat, that can open up some eyes nationally for your program? Because you're playing a ranked team or an almost ranked team.
Right, right. It is, you know, a should-be ranked team.
Right.
I think so. But, you know, we're not worried about opening up eyes. You know, you guys will open up. They will open up their eyes when they want to. You know, we just got to take care of business and stay focused and do the little things it takes to win.
Pat, can you tell us what's going on with Dontez Ford?
Yeah, I know you've been here a short time, but yeah, I'm not going to, you know, comment on injuries. We don't talk about him, and you know, he's a guy that I hope is back.
Is he going to play Saturday?
Okay, next.
What do you expect to see from them defensively?
You know, we expect to see an athletic crew that prepared for a lot of jet sweeps and motions and shifts. You know, they're very sound, I think. You know, they're similar to what we do defensively. They play a lot of quarters coverage, a little bit of man coverage, a little bit of zone blitz, not as much as we have. But you know, they'll be sound. They'll be well coached, like Mike Gundy football team. They'll be prepared.
Going into a game like this, after you had a week like you did offensively, do you encourage? Because obviously they're going to be looking really hard at those sweeps and jets and the sweeps and motions, and you can kind of, you know, open your playbook a little bit more and maybe keep them guessing.
Well, that's our job. I mean, you know, are we going to run all the same plays we did last week? Maybe. Do we have some other twist to it? Probably. And there'll be some stuff off it. So, I mean, we know what tape they're looking at. So we'll have stuff off of the plays. You know, plays off the plays.
What do you know about Mike Gundy and his staff?
Don't know a whole bunch about him. I've never played against him. You know, really like Coach Gundy. You know, one of my favorite rants. Coach Gundy, you know, I'm a man, you know, remember that? You guys all remember that? I mean, it's a classic, and he's so right in what he said, you know, so I have a lot of respect for, you know, who he is as a person. He's a super guy, play for him, coach with, so a lot of respect, not only as a football coach, but as a person.
You guys said.
Any of your receivers stand out this week in practice that you were impressed with?
Not any more than every other week. I mean, they've all, you know, done a good job. Quadri, Henderson, you know, they've all done, you know, a nice job.
You guys had 3 sacks in the fourth quarter on Saturday. It's kind of been a bit of a trend since you've been here, fourth quarter sacks. Do you sort of philosophically, when you're in tight games, close situations at the end, are you more inclined to dial it up to try and bring more pressure to sort of force the issue?
Not really. I mean, I think, you know, when you look at it, it wasn't all the interception at the end was pressure, but we didn't get sacked. We got, you know, we forced an overthrow or whatever that was. But, you know, I don't believe, you know, I'd have to go back and look at it. Those sacks were all pressures. I mean, a lot of times they're just 4-man pressures. You know, we come from anywhere. We come from the field, boundary, middle. So I think, you know, just the package itself is causes people problems. You know, from what I've heard, our coaches do a great job coaching it up, but our kids really, as I look at it, I watch them practice, they're doing the little things right most of the time and practice it with details. I think that's important.
Every game is different, and who knows what you'll do on Saturday, but have you dialed up more pressure this year than did last year?
I think we're probably less pressure this year than we were last year. Last year, we were about 37% on the year, and which I thought was too high. Maybe it's 38% on the year. You know, you'd like to be somewhere between 30 and 35, 34. Actually, just looking at some stuff there. Maybe we should go through that. Some self-scout stuff. But yeah, we'll look at our self-scout and know what we're doing based on down and distances. And, you know, self-scout basically is looking at what we're doing because that's what they're looking at. They're looking at when do we pressure. Do we pressure always on first down? Is it always on third down? And if we pressured a lot on third down, then we'll start to do less. You know, you build tendencies up to break. So we'll try to make ourselves look like that.
You're under 38, but, you know, what are you at right now?
I haven't got that yet. Coming to me about a half hour. You know, I would tell you this, after Villanova, because I've got that one, I just have to pull up. I'll give you guys some stats. That's a good soldiers. After the Villanova game, again, we'll wait to see where we were exactly, but after Villanova, we were 36% pressure. We were 63.1 base, and we were 36.9% pressure. So after Penn State, I don't know where it is, but, you know, hopefully a little less, but a lot of base. You know, we'll see. And, you know, but then we know it by exactly, by down and distance, by field position, by formation. We'll have it all mapped out. So when they come out and stuff, we know, hey, they're looking at this. They're thinking we're going to pressure that formation or not pressure formation. And we do the same thing.
Do you consider yourself a risk taker on defense?
I'm not the defense coordinator. I'm the head coach.
You consider Josh a risk taker?
Thank you, Chris.
You know, I think we're all risk takers. I think, you know, it's a risky game. People would tell you I'm risky, I would guess. I don't know if you ask somebody. Is that why you're asking?
Yeah.
People say we're crazy, probably.
I didn't say that.
You know, some people, you know, think some of the things we do is, you know, unconventional, I guess, but it's sound. And I just got a call from a team out west asking about, you know, I mean, it's a crazy call, but just asking what we do. But people are becoming more risky based on what we do and how we do it. So, you know, we're risky, I would say, but you know, I think it's what we do.
That improved defensive line, does that help you be a little bit more risky in terms of?
You want to be risky regardless. I mean, you can't be sitting back on your heels. We want to attack people. We want to go after them, and, you know, we're not going to sit back and say, oh, they're doing this, so we can't do that. Watch out. Be careful. You know, we want to be risky with the element of safeness.
I asked that.
You can do that.
I asked that.
When you talk risky, here's what I think. When you talk risky, I think man coverage. Okay, I think we've got maybe 7 snaps of man coverage on the. So risky is playing man and blitzing. We don't do that. That's not, to me, that's not risky. What we do is low risk, really, high reward.
You mentioned that quarterback on your conference call yesterday. What kind of talent is this?
You know, he's a big guy. He can throw the ball. He's got a great arm. Sometimes throws it too hard. You know, I think he can make every throw. I think he's an NFL quarterback here in a couple of years. And I think he's special. We got to change up our coverages to really keep him off kilter a little bit. I think he's a special quarterback.
You mentioned on Monday that they like to throw the ball downfield. What's his just threat that do to the rest of the defense?
It scares you. It scares you that if they connect on a few of those games, you can stop the run. But, you know, this corner's got a tough job at locking up down there and doing their job. And we'll have some change ups for them. You know, you go back to Notre Dame, what's that do for you? When, you know, go forward, run by your corner. It ain't easy. And they got some of those guys that can go like that. But you know what? You guys will be writing about how we're covering those guys. We put 2 on, we'll 4. All of a sudden, they're running the ball down our throat, and the clock's going tick tock, tick tock. Now what? You know, you want to run it down your throat, or you want to have to throw that ball down there? And if that quarterback is perfect, like last week, you know, the one thing we gave up, the kid had a hell of a catch, kind of like that, and we're right on him. That was a great catch. He brought it in one-handed. You know, they even had to go to the review to see if he got it. He's down right there. So, you know, they're going to catch it. If they go out and throw 10 of those and catch 8 of those, it's going to be a hard day for us. You know, we got to make a play. And if they're that good and they're on fire like that, then, you know, it's going to be tough to beat anybody.
How balanced are they on offense? Do they pass 60-40 or?
You know, overall, you know, let me check my stats. But I would say they're probably right now, I'm guessing offhand without looking at it, but I would say they're probably 60% pass overall. But right now they're 68% pass. About 68% pass on a breakdown we have for 304 plays. So that's not just the 2 games they played this year.
You said on the Monday that is there anything you've been impressed this week to maybe try to mimic that or maybe try to recreate what you might be facing?
You know, yeah, we've practiced with noise. You know, we haven't had any other angry people out there that to get after our guys. That's what you're talking about. Maybe, maybe Penn State fans out there would be all angry at them, maybe, you know, yell at them, scream at them, tell them they hate them. But no, we didn't have, you know, any of that. Our scout teams did a great job. And, you know, there's no way to prepare for that. I mean, the sideline, you know, is not as wide as this room. If you guys will see that, we'll be cramped. And I would say from this table to that window is about all we have space-wise. And the fans are right on top of you, and they'll be screaming at us the entire time. And that's really, you know, what you have to make sure. As I'm talking to you guys, are you paying attention to the fans that are screaming saying you stink, or are you paying attention to me giving you the adjustments for the next series? If you can't block them out, then we'll have a problem. So we'll talk to them about that.
How do you simulate their passing game in practice? That's a tough one.
It's not a tough question. I mean, how do you simulate it? You throw the ball down. We have all kinds of, I mean, it's what we do every week. It's our job. If you have pass Kelly, where you're, you know, you don't have the D line there, so there's no pressure on the quarterback, so he can throw the balls he wants without, you know, being pressured. And then you have team periods, so you give them a little bit of both. But, you know, can you get that speed that they have? No. But we did go against our offense, and I think, you know, Chester Williams, Tipton, and all those guys, you know, give us speed, so we do good on good, so we get the game speed of what we think we might have. But, you know, everybody releases a little bit different. Every wideout's a little bit different as far as what they do, how they do it, how they release. We, you know, prepare, you watch tape, and you hope your guys are better than their guys. That's, you know, I hate to tell you, that's kind of how it comes down to. Coach them up. If they run 4-2s out there, then we got problems.
How'd your backup quarterback end up on the kicker turn? Did he replace Dontez, or was that just
he started on that team, and he might be on a couple more. He's just a good football player. He was really good last year. You know, he was a receiver last year. He was on special teams. And we want to get him involved in the game. He's on scholarship right now. And he's a physical kid. He's athletic. He can run. Manny, you know, does everything he asked him to do. And he did a great job last week, too. If you go back and just isolate on him, you know, he's a quarterback that can play special teams. He might have something special with him somewhere, too.
I saw your locker room speech, and was it more impassioned or equally as impassioned as any other speech you've given so far?
I'd say equally. Every week you got to get cranked up. You only got that much.
I understand that. Unless I can sneak into the back of the room, you know.
But, you know, you got a little left up. But, you know, you better play with emotion every game. Or kids have to. You know, I don't think locker room speech is ever going to get a guy cranked up, because I think it ends like that. They better be cranked up and have their mindset better be the right frame of mind, and that's what we have to have again this week. You have to have it every week. It's an emotional game. Our sideline is cranked up, and we have to have that energy again this week.
You mentioned Manny. George Aston had 2 touchdowns. I think just to have guys that are former walk-ons earn a scholarship and contribute for the whole team, sort of the atmosphere.
Yeah, I think, you know, for everybody involved, you know, there's always going to be those walk-ons that earn scholarships. Think about how the team feels. You know, I mean, again, nobody's happy. You know, nobody's ever happy. But I think when the group is overall happy, and you see those things go on, it makes, you know, it gives them that trust that someday they may be that guy that has it and continue to work, progress towards what they'd like to have. But it's good for the team. You know, it's way above me. I told you guys before, they don't listen to me. I'm just over here. I had no idea yesterday. I walked out of a staff meeting, and, you know, look at the news. I had no idea. But Chris Lasalle, I told him after, he said, what? And he's sitting at his desk most of the time, you know, in front of a TV. But, you know, it'll be where it is. I just don't want, it's not going to be in North Carolina. And, you know, I don't care where that game is.
Yes.
Okay.
Thanks, Bob.